Scale is really important to me. When I was a little girl, my parents didn't want to buy me paper to draw on, so they let me draw over the walls in the apartment. So I remember being a very young girl, standing in front of white walls and just sort of using my entire body to draw giant whales. And I think that experience has stayed with me throughout the years. And then the second moment, important moment, happened when I moved from China to North Dakota. So I was living in a giant city where everything is really close to you. And then I stepped out of the apartment and I just sort of saw land stretch out around me endlessly, infinitely. And in my work, I really want to feel the scale of my body in relationship to the process and also the work. I want to feel like I'm being surrounded by something that's a lot bigger. Well, when I got to, I made these sheets of paper in Cleveland, Ohio, and one of the first things that I did when I got to Ohio was go to the edge of Lake Erie to watch the sunset, because that's what a tourist does. So, and I remember walking out into the water and seeing the horizon line meet the sky, and how that was barely perceptible, and it just seemed like there was, again, this idea of infinity stretching out before you. So I wanted to use the colors that I saw that night, and it was a lot of pinks and blues. And as far as the process is concerned, I work outside. So I use a lot of things like the movement of water, the viscosity of water, as well as gravity, temperature, weather, time, all of these things sort of intertwine together. As I'm making the work. And these are the ideas that I'm interested in talking about, you know, with my work. I think the most important thing is I'm interested in how something very, very minuscule or small can be large. So, you know, crouching behind an anthill when you're a little girl and thinking that it could be a mountain range. You know, so that's this, I guess, the sensation I'm looking for. I don't want to dictate what viewers feel, but that's what I'm looking for personally when I make these. So the reason I work with paper is because paper is just millions and millions of fibers interwoven together. And I think that people often have this experience of paper as, you know, just this material that you recycle or you throw away really quickly, or it's napkins that you use to wipe your mouth after you eat. But it can also be something else, and it could almost become unrecognizable from itself, from what we think it is. And that's what I would want people to experience.